Well, in 2012, more than 1,000 paintings looted from Jewish families by a Nazi art dealer were discovered in his grandson's home, now displayed at the Israel Museum. Luca de Villapan and Ben Levine have more on their origins and the museum's mission to reunite them with their rightful owners.
From Monet to Courbet to Gauguin to Munch, these masterpieces are now being displayed for the first time in Israel. A small part of what is known as Gurlitt's treasure. More than 1,400 works of master painters discovered by chance in 2012 in the apartment of Cornelius Gurlitt, a German retiree. Having died in 2014, he was the son of Hildebrand Gurlitt, a noted German art dealer who exploited Nazi Germany's persecution of the Jews. For years, this collector, like many others, took advantage of Nazi ideology to accumulate works considered as degenerate art by the Germans, works often belonging to Jewish families.
They started burning the works, but there was also an idea to sell the works outside Germany from foreign currency. And Hildebrand Gurlitt, who knew a lot of people outside Germany, was asked by the regime to come and sell for them works of art which they didn't want in Germany, sell them in Switzerland, in England, in America. So part of what he bought in order to sell outside is here. So he bought it from the collection of the state and kept part of it and sold part of it.
It's possible some paintings from the exhibition were stolen from their Jewish owners. Others may have been sold for funds for the Jewish families to flee the Nazis. Efforts have been underway to reunite the works with the heirs of the original owners, a move supported by the public. Under certain paintings, visitors can see whether a search for their rightful owner is in progress. For now, only 6 paintings from the Gurlitt collection have been returned.
When the fighting ended, I was 10 years old. So this is a dark period for me. The whole story of war and the art together, I find very interesting. And the history of this man is fascinating.
I am shocked about, like, the diversity. There's Japanese art, there's from every single century, and it is truly a wonderful treasure.
The exhibition, Fateful Choices, Art from the Gurlitt Trove, is open until the 20th of January at the Israel Museum.
That's all for our top stories here this hour at I-24 News. I'm David Matlin, live in Tel Aviv, and wherever you are in the world, thank you for joining us.